here at the back door of our Overland Center at 2428 Woodson Road. And I'm here to make a direct plea for water because we really need water every single day. We have different teams that are going out to minister to men and women who are experiencing homelessness. And we are all out of water bottles, and we desperately need this for this integral and very important part of our ministry at New Life Evangelistic Center. The men and women who are on the streets depend on us to get water. Without water, you can experience dehydration. It makes you lethargic, makes it hard to move around. And the lack of water is something that can even be deadly for people who are experiencing homelessness. When you are homeless, you are walking around, and often people experience stigma where others assume that they know your life story and all the different things that you've done, and they prevent you from getting access to basic needs like a bathroom or even water. And so we really need these water bottles. We go through so many of them, and here in this room, this is where we normally keep all of our water bottles. And as you can see, at different points in the year, this would be stacked to this high with cases of water bottles, and now we don't even have a single case. And so you can help minister to people who are experiencing homelessness by giving money to New Life to purchase the water, or by bringing cases of water to 2428 Woodson Road. And this is such an important need right now that you can fill. And when you do, you're ministering to the people who need Christ's love most. We want to be the hands and feet of Christ, and we do that by bringing food, water, clothing, and we share the gospel with people who are experiencing homelessness. And so you're a huge part of our ministry when you partner with us in this way. Please bring cases of water to 2428 Woodson Road. And by doing so, you play an important role in building God's kingdom, expanding compassion and love to people who need it most. Water is such an important necessity for human life. And without it, things can get so much worse for men and women who are experiencing homelessness. And like I said, our teams go out 365 days a year, 24/7, in the sense that we've got teams going out every single day to bring food, water, clothing, and hygiene kits, and the basic necessities of life. But we don't have any water right now, and we really need your help at this critical time. You can make a big difference. So come to our center here at 2428 Woodson Road. By doing so, again, you are sharing the love of Christ. And we really need your help at this time. The weather is still hot. Right now it's cooling down a little bit, but that the water is still a necessity. We need water all year round. And we can only help by people like you sharing your gifts. So please bring water today. We desperately need it. We're all out, and this makes it very hard for us to get water, that life-giving resource, into the hands of people who need it. So again, 2428 Woodson Road. Our hours were open from 8:30 to 4:30, Monday through Saturday. We're closed on Sunday. You can bring your water at any time, and we will have a team who can help you unload it, and we will get these water bottles into the hands of people who need it most. Please help out in this really important way. New Life Evangelistic Center is out here in Festus, Missouri. We're doing some street outreach. Reverend Rice and Brian Ireland, we're all out here trying to help people, and there a lot of them are living in the woods. Reverend Rice, we've seen a lot of people who are out here, and the counties are just not helping.
You're right, and this is where homeless people used to live, and they cleaned up and put their trash here, but Festus and Crystal City basically outlawed homelessness, and they pushed them out of here. They've been pushed back further in the woods. We're gonna see if we can find them back here. Gonna be looking there for them, and I've been told that they're gonna drive out of the woods here a week from now.
The fact is that that's what's happening. St. Louis County doesn't have any services at all. There's 90 municipalities in St. Louis County. We continue to find women, children sleeping in parks and out on the streets, and St. Louis County's not doing this job. That may be a sign that this is where the people may be.
Yeah, there's an American flag up in the distance, but, you know, there are lots of ways that you can help us in doing ministry like this. One of the ways is by becoming a monthly supporter for New Life Evangelistic Center. It costs a lot of resources to buy these tents, sleeping bags. We're able to get them for a good deal, but it still costs the ministry quite a bit of money. So when you support us on a monthly basis, that's a huge part of ministering to the gospel in this way.
It's like somebody's camping down out here, so let's see if we can put them in their tent. Hello, anybody here? We're from New Life. Anybody out here? Hey, how you doing? Hey, got some tent, sleeping bag, you need some food? How you doing? Morning. Looks like you're on the
other
side of the track.
Yeah.
How you doing, buddy? Are you having a good mood today? How are you?
Do you need any sleeping bags or anything like that?
Yeah. Good. Set up and keep it. Yeah. Well, I know the sleeping bags are wet. Okay. Now I've got some regular food here for you. Now, did you say that are there others around out here?
Yeah.
Good day. Okay. Okay. We got some cold food here, but I can maybe see if I get some hot food for you too, okay? And see if you can share this with somebody else too. Okay. And back there, is anybody living down this way? Looks like right at the very end of it. Uh-huh. They act like they're coming up. Up that way,
they never made it. Seems like, so next week they're going to try to come and run all of you out of here?
Yeah.
You got any idea where you're?
They down there yesterday.
Who was?
They down there yesterday, Captain. South Guerrero people.
Cops are back here?
Yeah. They took out and these railroad guys.
Oh, so this is railroad property they're saying?
Yeah,
this is
railroad. The levy property.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Is that through the county, the levees?
I don't know who it is. They're up there, dude.
Right. Okay, do you got any idea where you're going to go?
No.
None?
Nope.
I thought they had a big gathering Thursday, and they were going to try to help all the people get settled somewhere.
Yeah, for housing.
Yeah? Did they have anything?
I got to wait and call them on my birthday. 60 days. They're 60 days you got to call.
Oh, every 60 days? Because they don't have any room right now?
No.
Well,
I don't know what they're going to do.
Can I have a word of prayer? Can I have a word of prayer with you?
I thought about going out to the salt mines.
Oh. Where are they at?
Not the road, Louise.
Oh, is it? Let's have a word of prayer. Father, I come to you with this brother, Lord. I know you love him, and he's been through a whole lot. I ask that you'd give him direction for his life, Lord. I ask that, Lord, you would just be with him and encourage him and let him know that you are right there and help him to hear you and move under your direction. In Christ's name we pray, Lord, be with him. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Well, so what other kind of supplies do you need out here? Like toilet paper?
Toilet paper, butane.
Uh-huh. I don't have that.
Propane for beer.
Uh-huh. Okay. Don't have that.
Growing tank. For a lantern.
Actually, what we're doing this year is we're helping people make little canned heaters, which last longer and safer. We've got somebody in this propane tank. What we do is we get a gallon can, we put sand at the bottom of it, then we put a soup can like in there and put a candle in it, and then put a quart can over it, make a little heater, and heats the tent.
It'll last you all night, and it won't knock over or light anything on fire, but it's...
Yeah, my tent gets knocked over.
Everything in your tent gets knocked over.
It's safer with propane. But anyway, let us...
Mine, if it gets knocked over, it shuts off automatically.
Does it?
Does it? That's good.
Let me leveler thing in it.
Let me see if we can run and get some hot food and what we can get for you, okay?
All right,
we'll see you in a little while.
Right. We're gonna come back with some food for you.
See you. He looks like he wants some food.
Yeah.
I got 3 bags of dogs to go in
here. Oh wow, well that's good. He won't go hungry really.
Right now it's raining, Brian. A lot of people have to spend the night out in the weather.
Right. Yeah, it's not ideal for anybody when you don't have any option but to be outside. It's even worse.
Yeah.
So.
Well, we're going to continue to work with him. He said that maybe something open up in 60 days. We're going to continue to. There's others that are out here. We'll see if we find others. But in the meantime, we'll run and get some items that he may need, and we'll continue on. We have other teams that are going out in the city right now. Just praying that people get involved, because we're moving into what we call Socktober, and that's where we're really trying to help people this winter with the sleeping bags. They tend to get wet and dry them in and get them a replacement. And just tents and can heaters that I mentioned, on top of that, long underwear, just coats, of course, jackets, gloves, socks, all of that. So we're just... We don't receive any city, state, or federal dollars, so we're coming up trying to just reach out through the love of Christ, helping those that are hurting. And we thank God for the people that are donating right now, because we're out among the poorest to the poor, not only out here in this county, but St. Louis. Like I said, we've got teams going out there, St. Louis County, and teams in Saskatoon, and of course, Springfield, and that whole area. So just ask everybody to really pray for us, and just ask the Lord to work in you and through you, and share those gifts. New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. We want to follow Jesus anywhere and everywhere, and some of the neediest he's among.
There are a lot of people, we see all, everybody sees the problems, but if you want to be a part of the solution, like my grandfather was saying, you can make a big difference, become a monthly supporter of New Life. Any amount that you can do makes a big difference in the lives of many people in tangible ways. This is Pastor Chris Aaron Rice. I am here at our free store in Marshfield. NLEC has a free store in Marshfield, where we are serving the local community in a variety of different ways. And I want you to meet the man who helps clean it and direct it, Timothy, who's in our leadership training program. And we're going to show you what the free store looks like. So stay tuned here with us as we talk about, we're going to talk about the NLEC Route 66 free store. And we want you to follow their Facebook page as well, because they've got a lot of different events that are going on. And this is, again, just another outreach of NLEC. We've got several different locations, and so we want to share with you this one in particular this morning. So I'm standing right outside the front of our free store, and here it is, NLEC, New Life Evangelistic Center free store. And Tim Graves, he is the one who kind of heads up. Hi, Tim. How are you doing today?
I'm blessed.
All right. So tell us, how long is the free store open? What are the hours?
9 a.m. to 6 p.m.
Monday through Friday?
Yeah, and I open on Sunday someday, too, for the people that work during the week.
So 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. And how many people do you think are coming to use this service?
When I first got here, for the first 2 months, it was like 3 or 4. But now we start the new page, Facebook page. I'm getting maybe 20, 30 a day some days.
Wow. 20 to 30 people were coming in here for this free store. Do people come and bring you donations?
Yes. We're getting 2 to 3 big trailer full. I got a small trailer I made. Trailer full of donations a day.
Yeah. So what's this building behind you right here? What's that building?
That's where me and Robert, the other guy that works with me out here, that's our living quarters, in the radio station, TV station.
Yeah, so if somebody wants to tune in to the radio station, do you know what channel they go to?
Yeah, 1510 KMRF.
That's for the AM, right?
AM and then 107.1 FM.
107.1. So if you're in the area and you want to listen to some good gospel music, some good sermons and different things like that, you can tune into our radio station. And what's that radio station again for FM?
107.1.
And then if you want to tune into the AM, it's 1510. You can see that. I can't really see it on the tree here. But this is where they would park. Anyone who's coming to our free store, they can park right here in this area, and you said you built that trailer, didn't you, yes, right there? Yeah. So how much land right now is here that we own?
It's all the way down there where you see the grass cut to the white fence down there.
Mm-hmm.
To the tree line all the way over to past that top big tower right over there.
Yep, you can see kind of the radio tower over there, and this is what we broadcast actually out of our new Bloomfield Center. And so it's all the same broadcast. And again, if you want to listen to New Life Evangelistic Center and you're in the Marshfield area, you can tune in to 107.1 for FM and 1510 for the AM station. And my dad, Chris Rice, he's also...
You have to tell them about the app, too. They can listen to the radio station on the app, so you don't have to even be in Marshfield.
That's right. Yeah, my dad, just remember, Facebook friends, we've got an app, NLEC TV, that you can download and listen to our radio station at any time. But if you want to listen to local, we've got that here in Marshfield. So let's actually go into the free store now, and we'll show you all that's in that. So once people come in, they bring in their donation, or maybe they are in need and need some clothing, they can come in here. And so we've got this nice building here, this free store, where we can supply the needs of people who may not have the ability to buy some clothing. Right, Tim?
Yes, yes. We got a lot of women clothing. The main thing we need is children and baby clothing and men clothing.
Mm-hmm.
And since I've been here, I started giving out food items, cans and box foods and stuff,
mm-hmm.
to try and help the community. Like I said, since I've been here and I've been doing a lot of more stuff here, we're getting a lot more people coming in and donating.
Mm-hmm.
And on our radio stations, we're also asking people to contact us for they can run their ads through our radio stations.
Wow. So you guys are doing your best to provide a real community service to Marshfield.
Yes.
So you see 20 to 30 people coming in every single day. Tell me a little bit about some of the people who have come in to get some of this help. Are they, describe what are some of the things that they're struggling with sometimes?
Some of them lost their jobs or trying to get on their disability. I got a couple of grandparents that has got just recently getting custody of their children,
mm-hmm.
and come in, and one of the things they need is, with so many people in the house, the extra food is helping them. They need certain clothing items and stuff, so I get on my Facebook page, Route 66 NLEC Free Store, and I'll ask the community, and within a day or two, the community steps right in and brings us what we need to help the rest of the community.
Right. Is this one of the few free stores, really, where people can get access to the clothing and yes. things that they
yes,
need?
Yes, because when I first got here, a lot of people come in and say, this is a free store. I said, yeah. Well, where's the free section? I'm like, the whole place is a free section. Well, every store we go in, they say it's free. They just got one small section. I tell them, no. Anything's in here, help yourself. Just think of the people that come in after you, you know. So get what you need. You can come back next week and get more if you need it. Just think of the others just come in after you. And most of the time, the people that come in are bringing bags of clothes with them to donate. And we fill out a little donation slips and give them. And it's just a wonderful thing that we're doing out here. And I got a few people that just come in and just standing here and talking, don't even really want nothing. It's a lot of older people just get out their house and got somewhere to go. And yeah. I was with Chris Aaron up at Walmart and had a couple women stop and talk to me. He like, well, you have made yourself popular out here. I said, it's good that even away from the store, they know who I am and what I do and that we're doing a good thing for the community.
Yeah. So how, you know, you yourself are in our leadership training program. How has this work really helped you grow in your own personal faith?
Oh, man. When I first got here, I was just getting off the streets and was an addict and wasn't drinking, but I was using. And down in New Bloomfield for a year. And it really, really helped me. I started getting my health together. my spiritual. And now that I'm up here, it's like I'm another person, because the work that I'm doing with the community and help is what I love to do anyway.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so you've really grown in your own faith, and you've just seen many different ways to minister to other people, too. How often do you get to pray with them and talk to them about Jesus?
I talk to them every day about Jesus, and sometimes people ask me to pray for them, or they ask, can they pray for us? And it's on the daily basis that they come in, and either I'm praying or someone else is praying.
Yeah. So here, you see how clean the free store is? There's my dad again. Tim does a good job of keeping shop and making sure that all the supplies are clear, and you can just find what you need at any time. But again, what he said was, we really need children's clothes and we really need men's clothing, because the deal is that women, they get rid of clothes really quickly. They want to, you know, get new clothes for their wardrobe and stuff. But men, we tend to wear it out.
Until they can't wear it no more.
Right. So I have some shirts that I've had since my college days or even earlier than that. And the reality is that men, we need your clothing. So listen to your wives. Get rid of that old T-shirt that you've been wearing since you were way too young, and bring it to and give it to somebody who needs it more. We need more men's clothing, and we also need children's clothing here in this area so that we can help other people. Men's clothing, children's clothing, and we've got some special events that are coming up, don't we, Tim? Tell me a little bit about those events.
October 8th, the Chamber
of Commerce. What's happening there, Dad?
Well, they're coming out and they're going to do a ribbon cutting for us.
Wow.
And we're going to also have a picnic here, and Tim's going to fire up the grill and cook in, and we just want to have a beautiful, I'll bring my guitar, we'll have a nice gospel sing on the ground, and it'll be a great day.
Okay, so if you're in Springfield or near Marshfield, then, our hope and our desire is that you come out with us on October 8th. I think my grandfather's going to join you guys on that day.
Ten o'clock,
and we're going to have some good food, music. We're just going to celebrate all that God is doing here in Marshfield in particular. And we want you to join us for that event. We may be doing some Facebook Live during that time. So we want you to put that on your calendar, 10 o'clock, October 8th. What are some other events that are coming up in the year?
November 2nd, we're doing a kids from newborn through high school coat giveaway. We're asking anybody in the community or anywhere to bring any used or new coats that you can bring to us, because we really need them. It's going to be from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m., first come, first serve. You must bring an ID and proof for the children. We have on the Christmas giveaway, toy giveaway, December the 11th. Yeah. Same thing, you must bring an ID and proof for the kids, any used or new toys, or even gift cards we could use desperately to help the community and help the families that are really struggling and going through it. And I know there's plenty of us out there that can give extra and help. I can't give extra, but I'm doing it all I can with what I can do with the store and the radio stations and everything out here. So please come out and visit us and enjoy and pray with us in the store, and let's have a fun time at our events out here, and everyone's welcome.
Yeah, Tim. Amen. So
I could just the actual ribbon cutting is at 1:30 that day October 8th, but we're going to have our get-together, our gospel sing, all that, starting at 10.
Great.
And, so
come at 10.
We're going to go live on the air, too, at that time. And what we want is area businesses to call Tim and hook up with us. And basically what we're going to do is we're going to advertise your business.
Mm-hmm.
And we've got some great rates for doing that.
Mm-hmm.
We'd also welcome trade-ins as well, for material, for labor, those types of things. And you can call Tim. What's your number, Tim?
573 353-2213. Or you can, my email is gravest959@gmail.com.
Mm-hmm. So there are a number of different ways that you can help out. And if you're a local business or you want to expand your business to the Marshfield area, our radio station covers Marshfield. What else does it cover?
Well, 1510 actually covers northern Springfield, too.
Mm-hmm.
So, and Marshfield is the county seat for Webster County.
Right.
So we reach into Webster County, too.
Yeah. So there are so many ways that you guys can get involved, but we wanted to show you this location of NLEC because we're not just in Springfield, we're not just in St. Louis. We've got areas all throughout Missouri, and Marshfield is one that Tim has really taken, and Tim and my dad, all of the team have really taken by the, and Robert, they've taken this and really made it a nice location where ministry is really taking place. And so we don't want you to miss all of the exciting things that are happening here. There's Robert here. He's also helping out Tim in a variety of different ways. We've got books for people to read. And again, every single thing in this store is free. And so...
Except Tim and Robert.
Except Tim and Robert. They are not free. But we wanted to show you a little bit of the property, how they have managed it, and how they're doing all of this good work for the Lord. Ministry is really taking place here in Marshfield. So please pray for our team out here. Pray for all of those who are coming, that they would receive the love of Christ in tangible ways. Pray that ministry would continue and that we would be able to supply the needs of the community here locally. And that as we seek to promote our radio station and all of these different things, that the gospel would be declared clearly and succinctly and people would be saved. That's our main goal here at New Life Evangelistic Center. And so I'm amazed at how God is using this small building to really reach so many different people. Please pray for Tim, pray for my father, and pray for Robert as they seek to minister to people out here in Marshfield. And may God be glorified by his ministry out here. We thank you so much for supporting New Life Evangelistic Center. Please keep us all in your prayers as we seek to see all the needs throughout Missouri and fill them with gospel-like compassion and hope. At the same time, our financial needs are incredible. It takes a lot of money to operate a ministry with so many different locations. So if the Lord is moving in your heart right now to partner in tangible ways, please consider giving right now because the financial needs are really incredible. God is good and our hope is set in his unchanging character. But we need you right now to partner with us in prayer, through volunteering and coming to our different events, and by giving your tax-deductible gift right now. Thank you so much for watching, and God bless you and your family.